The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Genesis, chapters 37 and 39.
The Bible. It's God's one big story, the epic adventure of how He created us and how He loves us so much He made a way to rescue us even when we turned our backs on Him. And as we travel through the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who actually met God and found their lives changed forever. God had promised to grow Abraham's family into a great nation. Abraham's son Isaac and his grandson Jacob had made many mistakes, but God was still faithful and gave them many children. Jacob alone had more than a dozen.
I have the finest sons in all of Canaan.
Jacob's next to youngest son, Joseph, spoke up.
About that, Dad? Dan and Asher let a bear steal 3 sheep because they were too busy setting up a locust race.
Joseph's older brothers glared at him.
Tattletale!
Is this true?
Yeah, they're not very good at racing locusts or watching sheep.
Joseph's brothers all knew that he was the favorite. In fact, Jacob had given him this beautiful coat woven with many colors, and telling the truth didn't make him any more popular with his brothers either. Soon after, Joseph joined Reuben, Dan, and Simeon, and the rest of the brothers out in the fields.
Hey! Anybody want to hear my dream?
No.
Okay, so we were all tying up bundles of grain, right? And then all of your bundles of grain bowed down to mine. Oh yeah, like that would ever happen. Just telling you what I saw.
Reuben pulled Jacob aside.
If you have any more dreams, little brother, keep them to yourself.
A short while later, Joseph did have another dream, but this time, he didn't keep it to himself.
There were 11 stars, that's you guys, bowing down to me.
Joseph, you're not doing yourself any favors here.
But Joseph was so fascinated by his dreams, he couldn't stop talking. Sometime later, he even told his father.
The moon and sun were bowing down to me too.
Joseph, my boy, you're a fine young man, but don't get big ideas. You really think your mother and I would bow down to you?
I'm just telling you.
I have an errand for you. Your brothers are caring for the flocks near Shechem now. Go see how everything's going, then come back and tell me.
Okay. Sure, Dad.
So Joseph brushed off the sleeves of his beautiful coat and set off for Shechem. When he arrived, his brothers were nowhere to be found. A local man pointed him in the right direction.
Well, they up and left, bless your heart. You're going to Dothan, I heard him say.
So Joseph set out once more across the wide, empty plains, and as he neared Dothan, he could see his brothers and their flocks off in the distance. His brothers could see him approaching, too.
Oh, you're kidding me. Is that who I think that is?
Dream boy himself.
This. Now, this is an interesting situation.
Huh?
We're in the middle of nowhere. We could send Joe to, sleep with the fishes. And no one would ever know.
I don't like seafood.
I mean, bump him off. Put him on ice.
Judah jumped in too.
Then we dump him in an empty well, nice and easy.
Their eldest brother Reuben heard these plans.
You can't kill him, but if you want to mess with him, okay. Just put him down in this empty well.
Reuben couldn't stomach what his brothers were about to do, so he went to go search for a sheep that had strayed. Yeah.
They'll get bored of this. I can sneak Joseph out later and get him home.
The other brothers watched with glee as Joseph arrived.
Hey, Dream Boy.
Yeah, things are about to get a little less dreamy for you.
The brothers circled Joseph, tugging off his coat.
Hey, what are you doing? Dad says...
Simeon and Dan grabbed Joseph by one arm.
Dad's not here.
And he's definitely not down there.
Before Joseph even had time to think, his brothers had dropped him down into a dry well.
You can't do this! It's dark down here!
Brilliant observation, Sherlock.
The brothers ignored Joseph's cries and sat down to dinner.
You have to get me out sometime. I am so over that whining.
Look! Dudes! Traitors!
A caravan of camels loaded with spices trekked right up to the brothers' camp. Judah furrowed his brow.
Joseph's no good to us if we hurt him. We gain nothing. But if we sell him...
we can get some cash money!
The brothers carried out their terrible plan. They pulled Joseph from the well and sold him to the traders for silver coins.
This is not fair.
Bye-bye, dream boy.
Hope you like Egypt.
Later, Reuben returned to check the well, planning to sneak Joseph out. But it was empty.
He's gone. What am I supposed to do now?
Calm down. He's not dead.
But what do I tell our father?
Judah held up Joseph's brightly colored coat.
We do have this.
Ah, yes. I see a tragic story unfolding right now.
The brothers took Joseph's coat and dipped it into the blood of a goat, and then they took it to their father.
So, Dad, we found this. Does it belong to Joseph?
That's his robe.
Jacob examined the bloodstains in horror.
A wild animal must have attacked him. He's dead. My son is dead. I will mourn him until I die.
The brothers exchanged glances. No one, not even Reuben, spoke up with the truth that their brother was still alive. In fact, Joseph had been taken to Egypt and sold to a man named Potiphar, who was the captain of the Pharaoh's guard.
I'm new here. I don't know how to walk like an Egyptian.
Then you'd better learn.
Even though Joseph was now a slave in a foreign land, God was still with him. And over the next few years, God gave Joseph success in everything he did.